Hello, and welcome to the Soil Health Assessment video series. My name is Brian Doherty. I'm an Ag Engineering Field Specialist with Iowa State University Extension and Outreach. And in this series, I'm going to go through how to assess the health of your soil. This can be on the farm, in your garden, in your yard, really anywhere that you want to do a soil health assessment. So I'm mostly going to focus on visual soil health indicators, but later in the series, I'll also get into some other simple experiments and tests that you can do to assess your soil health. So let's get started.
Okay, so before we start digging holes, there's a few simple things that we need. So all you really need to do a visual soil health assessment is a good pair of eyes and a shovel. So really any shovel will work that you can dig soil up with. I like this design. It's a short-handled spade. It's got a nice long blade on it, so if you're later in the season, you want to dig up some roots, get down deeper in the profile. This is a nice design, and the short handle just makes it easier to transport. You can throw it behind the seat of the pickup and have it with you wherever you go. The second thing that I really recommend if you're going to do any soil health assessments is some sort of a scorecard or a way to evaluate the soil health. So here's one option. This is a nice little pocket guide from Iowa State University Extension and Outreach. So I'll post a link to this at the end of the video. This is available through the Extension store. But in this guide, there's a little assessment card in the back that you can use to score your soil health. So that's one option. You can just Google soil health assessments. You might be able to find some others online. I've also got one here that I put together. It's just kind of a combination of a few different assessments. I'll post my contact information at the end of the video with my email, so you can feel free to call me or shoot me an email, and I'm happy to give you a copy of this free of charge. So another good thing to have is a camera. Just take pictures, just some way to keep a record of what you've seen. So that way, if you want to compare, one field to another, you've got a way to kind of assess that. These are somewhat subjective, obviously, because every person will have a different idea of what the score should be, but at least if you're doing the assessment, you have a fairly reasonable way to track that. And it's also great if you want to track it over time, come back to the same field 2 or 3 years later, you can see how your soil health is progressing. So let's dig some holes.
So before we start evaluating soil, I want to give you a little bit of a background on the site here where I'm going to be pulling these samples. So this is actually a family farm up in Almaquis County here. So very northeastern Iowa. These are Fayette silt loam soils. And so what I'm going to do here, the field we're looking at was in corn last year. So it was corn silage was chopped off last fall and it had dairy manure applied. It was tilled and then seeded to a cereal rye cover crop. So on the right here, you see the cover crop. So what I'm going to do is pull up some soil from this cover crop here. You can see some point rows here that were skipped. So I'll pull up some soil from that area. We can compare that to the cover crop ground. And then over here is an old fence line. And so this is a really good idea if you're doing a soil health assessment to try to find some area nearby with the same soil type that's been undisturbed. Ideally, got some perennial vegetation on it, been undisturbed for, a long time. And that kind of gives you a baseline to compare your soil to. So if you can find some soil somewhere nearby, and that way you can, kind of get an idea maybe what your soil used to look like or what it potentially could look like if you start working on soil health. So highly recommend that as a comparison, and that kind of gives you a benchmark when you're doing your soil health scoring. So the first thing I do doing an assessment before I would even dig up the soil is just take a look at the surface. And so this ground here, obviously quite bare, it had corn silage, so very little residue. It was tilled up. There's basically no surface cover there. And so I would score that, pretty low on a 1 to 10 scale, 1 being very degraded, 10 being very healthy. I'd probably give that maybe a 2. There's some evidence of surface crusting there. So just generally not in great condition based on surface cover. So come over here to our cover crop. Definitely much better. We've got some ground cover there, but still some bare spots, not much residue in between. I'd maybe score this, maybe a five. So again, very subjective, but once you do a few of these, you'll get the hang of it. So now I'm going to dig up some soil from these three areas and we'll take a look.
Okay, we've got our three samples pulled up here. So what you're looking at on the left is a sample from the bare ground here where the silage is chopped off. The one in the center is from the cereal rye cover crop. And the one on the right is from the fence line. So one of the first things you would look at doing a visual assessment is color. So I hope you can see this on the camera here, but you can clearly see that that soil from the fence line is a darker color than the other two. So good indication there that there's probably quite a bit more organic matter in that soil. So you have to be a little bit careful, when you're assessing color because it will change depending on the moisture content of the soil. So just make sure you're doing an apples to apples comparison there. So the second thing I would start looking at would be kind of the structure of the soil or the aggregation of the soil. And so you can see on the left here where we had our bare ground, this soil is very, I'd call that platy. There's not a lot of structure there. When you break this open, it's pretty homogeneous because of the tillage. There's some micro aggregates there, but not it crumbles fairly easily, so that's a good sign, but not a lot of good aggregation there because we don't have any roots growing here, and so that's kind of preventing this soil from aggregating. So now we look at our cereal rye cover crop. So what's kind of amazing to me is these were both tilled last fall, but if you look at this cover crop, we've only got a couple inches of growth here on the surface, but look at the aggregation. It's already starting here just within a few months with this cover crop. We've got roots down probably almost a foot. I didn't dig all the way down, but so this can be a little misleading. You might look at a cover crop, doesn't look like there's much there, but there's a lot more going on below ground than above ground. We've got earthworms in here. This soil is going to hold together much better in a rainfall event. These roots really help hold it together. You can see the aggregation starting there. So that's what a cover crop can do for your soil. That's what we want to see. Now over here, this is our reference from the fence line. Again, you can see much darker color. It's got kind of a cottage cheese type look, which is, kind of what we want to see. It's very crumbly, very good aggregation here. Again, lots of roots, lots of organic matter in the soil. So this is a good comparison, if we're doing an assessment. And again, if I was going to score these on a 1 to 10 scale, over here on the left where we had our bare soil, this is probably going to score, if I was doing it, maybe a three, something like that. Got decent color here, fairly crumbly, but again, we don't have any roots here. A little bit of evidence there of some earthworm channels, but not a very healthy soil. Here we're probably more in the mid-range. I'd probably give this a, five or a six. Not great aggregation there, but certainly better than the bare soil. Over here, this is definitely going to be, an 8 to 10 range. This is going to indicate, pretty close to what a native soil would have looked like in this area. I'm going to wrap it up for there. Check back in. I'll have more videos in this series, and we'll talk more about assessing soil health. So thanks for joining, and I'll see you next time.